The mouth of the city. I mingle with the chic while I'm
rolling with the gritty.
You are tuned in to the GaptoothDiva Show.
Hello, welcome to the GaptoothDiva Show. I'm so excited to have you. This is our first episode. Do not adjust your television. I am chocolate with blonde hair, okay? And you are watching the GaptoothDiva Show because you know that you're in for inspiration, empowerment, motivation, and fabulousness. Okay, I'm just excited that you are tuning in. Please tell a friend to tell a friend to tell a friend to watch the GaptoothDiva Show because we're getting ready to get into some exciting things. I have some great guests on my first show. Today is all about celebrating individuality, awesomeness, flossomeness, being yourself, being curvaceous, being who you are, and using your God-given talents. No additives added, I'm trying to tell you, okay? Make sure you also check out GaptoothDiva.com after the episode for some great, great news. Okay, before we get into anything, I just want to say that I'm thanking Comcast for giving me my show and thanking the wonderful Joey Chancellor for being the executive producer. Now, how y'all doing today? How are you doing, okay? Now, today, we're going to talk about the current events. Let's just get it out the way because they're all at the top of our head. Number one, government shutdown. Okay, the government shutdown. How many of you still had to go to work? How many of you still had to pay your bills? I tried to tell Dominion Power that I wasn't going to pay my bill today because the government shut down, and they said, play with me. If you want to, I will shut them lights down. Okay? Now, because they're going back and forth in the government, playing around with Barack Obama and trying to give him a hard time is why the government's having a hard time. And let me just tell you, if you do not vote, you cannot make not one complaint. So let me just say, if you're not at the polls doing anything significant, like pressing a button and saying, this is the person I want in office, then you can't do anything but sit here and just talk, just yap them gums, okay? Now, also, there are rumors that Miss Miley Cyrus, you know who she is, Google her. She's the new ratchet woman out there, and she's that color. But anyway, Miss Miley Cyrus is pregnant, and apparently she's supposed to be pregnant with Juicy J's baby. Let me just say, now, as ratchet as she is, we do not want her to have any children. Especially, look what she did at the VMAs with the teddy bears and all that stuff. We don't want her around children toys like that, wearing patent leather with no booty. We don't want none of that happening. But Miley Cyrus is doing that. I want you to know that we don't want her to have children. Please give her some birth control. Please don't let her have any kids, especially not Juicy J kids, because he did make that song, Bands Make You Dance. I don't know what's going on with this young lady. Remember when she was on Disney? Oh, let's just think back just for a second. Remember when she was on Disney? Back in the days, I tell you. All right. Awesome. I had the pleasure of checking out Kanye West's interview. Go to rapradar.com and check out this interview. The most prolific thing that I've ever seen in my life. Let me just tell you, if you're not a fan of Kanye, I completely understand. Some people don't like him. Some people do. He is very cocky and arrogant, but I think that you need some of that, especially with the lack of confidence that's going on around here. People need to have some cockiness and some arrogance with them. But in this interview, he talks about why he's cocky and why he's arrogant. We all have come from a past where we were told we couldn't, we shouldn't, we're not supposed to. And he was in that past as well. And what he did was he utilized all the gifts that he had, all the talent that he had around him, and decided, you know what, I'm going to be my own biggest fan. He thought of himself as being a god. He thought of himself as being better than, because he was told he couldn't do most things. Now, if you watch this interview, you will hear why. You will also hear why he feels as though in the industry, they are causing us to be slaves. We're slaves to fashion. We're slaves to materialistic things. We're even slaves to society and what we're told we're supposed to have when it comes to media, mainstream media. Everything is being forced down our throats. And he says he refuses to be a slave. But at the same time, he wants to use his talents to make him a legend. And I think that whatever you're doing in your life, whatever purpose you have, you want to leave some type of lasting legacy. You want people to say, hey, I remember when things used to be like this, but they changed because of this person. And you want them to say your name. And that's how I feel. I mean, I feel like I can personally identify with him because I'm not one of those people that will let people tell me what I can and cannot do. And one of the biggest things that he mentioned in this interview is that if they can't control you, they don't want anything to do with you. And that's how society is. If they can't control you, most of the time they will say, get rid of her. We don't want anything to do with her because we can't tell her when, where, or why. And that's how it was. He made so much money, but they couldn't control him. I think you should check it out. Go to rapradar.com and check out this interview. It's one of the most prolific things that I've ever seen. Also, if you're going to be around on October the 4th and you're not doing anything, take your family out to Bowtie Theater and check out Troop 491. Young Prince Charles is in this movie, and this movie is about young children, how they're growing up in the hood, how they're growing up in society, and how brotherly love can change even just the biggest of circumstances. And if you happen to be around Bowtie Theater at 7 p.m., I definitely think you should check out this movie. Support Young Prince Charles. Support kids trying to do something with talent. And just support black films. This is going to be an amazing opportunity for you. Take your family out. Take your kids out and get them inspired. And if you're in business, you want to make sure that you're networking. You want to make sure people know who you are, your name, your face, and what you bring to the table. And one of my favorite networking events, and it's because it's free, I'm not going to lie, is Meet Your Tweet. Please follow Yoshiko Entertainment on Twitter and on Facebook because she has a Meet Your Tweet event. She's starting it back up, and I'm so excited. This is the kind of event where you meet mature adults. Everybody is networking, they're talking about their business, but it's not something that's gonna suck the money right out your pocket because entrepreneurs ain't got it like that sometimes. I mean, seriously, some of us are broke. So go to this event. It's gonna be at Flatheads, which is at 3125 Wharf Street. Get a boat tour, try some drinks, network with some like-minded individuals, and it's all for nothing. I really suggest that you go, especially if you're just starting your business or you're a new entrepreneur. This is a fantastic opportunity for you to meet and greet with new people. Also, make sure that you go to Style Mart this weekend to donate your new or gently used shoes for the Dress for Success Central Virginia. Dress for Success is doing things, helping people in the community. So you want to make sure that you donate as soon as possible. And one of my favorite events, I'm so excited, and you will see me there. And if you see me, make sure you tap me on the shoulder so I can get a fashion picture of you because I do this every year. We're going to be in Jackson Ward at the Second Street Festival where there's music, there's family, friends, food, and live entertainment. It's going to be exciting. Please do not smoke in front of your children and don't smoke around mine. I cannot stand the smoke. I don't want it in my hair, the little bit that I do have, and I do want to enjoy myself with my family. So make sure that you're out there, and if you're fashionable and you're fly, you will get featured on GaptoothDiva.com, so make sure you see me. So shout out to Venture Richmond for doing an event like this because it's one of the most amazing events for the black community, and it does bring us all together. I'm so excited to get our guest on the show. Today's about individuality. It's about being yourself. And I couldn't think of anybody better to have on the show than the two people that I have today. And it's my first show. I can do what I want. So I invited one of my closest friends. First is Andrea Bennett. She is the CEO of Fat Divas Modeling Agency, and she's a fellow plus size model. Also a Huguenot alum, so we went to school together. Andrea, how are you? You look amazing. I love this polka dot. She was just killing me right now.
Thank you.
All types of like mahogany you bring into the table, doll face. I see you. Oh my gosh. Too much. We're about to tilt the scales because it's about to be too much fabulous in here. Why? Because we're going to bring up another guest. Been doing hair for a long time since he was 15. Female impersonator, great entertainer, hairstylist extraordinaire, and the founder of the Hair Battle Royale, Mario Lee, also known as Fennix Baldwin. Woo! Look at you. It's just too much sexy. It's like it's too much going on. They about to shut everything down up in here. How you doing, Fennix Baldwin?
I'm fine. How are you today?
Fabulous. You had an event this past weekend. How was it?
It was great. I want to say shout out to the lovely Zakia Jamal Sia.
Yes.
I did host this weekend.
Yes. It was a successful event.
Very successful.
And you know, I know you brought it to the microphone like just terribly fierce.
Yeah. You know me. I'm just fierce all the way around the board.
Wow. I'm just excited to have the both of you. Like I said, this show is about individuality. It's about being yourself, being the greatest at what you do. But I know that you both came from, you know, a past where being yourself wasn't always accepted. And that's why I wanted to have you on the show, is because being yourself is something that's important to me, and having individuality is something that you can exemplify. And I know that, you know, with what you have going on, that it's an opportunity for you to share your story. Okay, so we're gonna get into a 30-second break really quick. Where and when we come back, we're gonna come back with Zenobia Bay, Crab Out the Barrel EPK, just in a moment.
Good job. Good job. I didn't
know. You know, back in slavery time, that's where a lot of the selling and the importing and everything was going on. So it's quite natural that a lot of their spirits and feelings and emotions of our ancestors that went through that is down here. So we can take it on the negative part and, you know, be rebellious or be, you know, have that slave mentality like a lot of them did, didn't get their own businesses. Well, you can do that. And I felt my energy going more towards being entrepreneur, owning my own business, and pretty much giving back.
Pleasure of speaking with today.
Z-Bay, the poet, Phoenix, Zenobia Bay, Community 50-50. I got like 15 different names, but you know, Zenobia Bay, aka Z-Bay, the poet. And so we out here in the heart of Richmond, VA. This is Southside. You know, this is where I was born and raised. So pretty much, Crab Out the Barrel hashtag COTB is a way of thinking. You know, I just pretty much came up with that concept based off how I grew up, what I've seen, and how so many people, they try to do things, people always try to bring them down. So, you know, I traveled the world with a college player, went over to Germany and got a different culture experience. When I came back, I just seen Richmond in a different light. You know, so I always had a passion for music, giving back, helping people, letting people know, you know, always the negative route is not always the way. You know, I always made mistakes, still make mistakes, but pretty much through my nonprofit, which is Community 50-50, you know, we give back, you know, and it's, that's what it's about, giving back. When you pretty much have a lane and an outlet, you don't sit back and just do what you do and don't give back. You gotta, you know, pretty much reach and help somebody else. So, Z-Bay, Crab Out the Barrel.
All right, so what's the mentality of people in the RVA when it comes to supporting the local independent artists? What's your thoughts on that?
It's tough. I mean, like, you know, people say if you make it in New York, you can make it anywhere. I feel like if you make it out of Richmond, you can make it anywhere. It's so much talent here in Richmond, but a lot of people don't support. A lot of people don't take that time to listen to something new. They feel like, oh, I know them, or I know somebody that know them, so, you know, they're not doing that, or they may be intimidated by things that they're doing, so they don't want to support local artists. There's a lot of local artists that's in Richmond that's hot, you know, whether it's hip-hop, reggae, soul, R&B, you know, pop. Just go out and support them, but a lot of people we don't support, and I think it's that crab in the barrel mentality. You know, they don't want to see nobody getting up, or they don't want to see nobody getting up to a level that they feel like they're not going to succeed. But if you build a team and you know everybody working together, everybody going to win. So I mean, it it really needs to elevate people's mentality of support. You see a flyer, you think it's something that you may be interested in, it's $5, $7, go check it out. You know, it can't hurt, you know. So I just think the people in Richmond just need to pretty much just look at a different style of music, realize everything ain't just radio. What you hear on the radio is not what you're gonna hear some of these local artists. You know, a lot of local artists are conscious. So it's that crab in the barrel mentality, you know, they just need to support on it.
Okay, so that was Zenobia Bay, Crab Out the Barrel, for her EPK, for her mixtape and album. What I love about Zenobia Bay is she represents exactly the epitome of being an individual. A lot of people are not going to support you. For some reason, people feel like it's a stifling environment here in Richmond, Virginia. But with Zenobia Bay, she takes her creative spoken word and hip-hop mix and makes an album dedicated to inspiring people to be that crab out of the barrel. Not only is she a spoken word and hip-hop artist, she's also the founder of Community 50/50, which is a nonprofit organization dedicated to empowering young people and families to not only live better lives, but also through music, get more involved with the community. I feel like she's one of the most inspiring women doing something in Richmond because she chooses to be an individual. She loves being herself, but she also loves inspiring young people and families alike through her music and through her spoken word. If you want to check her out, make sure you check her out at community5050.org or follow her on Twitter at ZBayThePoet. And that's T-H-A for all those people who like Ebonics, okay? Make sure you follow her and you support her. Now we're getting ready to get into one of my favorite parts of the show, which is the music video, okay? And I chose to pick Uncle Reese, who has a new song called Until I Pass Out. Very inspiring, very motivating. If you know anything about me, I'm very spiritual and I love the Lord. We're not perfect, but I love God with all my heart. So I want to make sure that you check out Uncle Reese. He started off with a very promiscuous past, and he was into alcohol and drugs, and he was into a lot of trouble. And if it wasn't for two persistent people who wanted to make sure that he got into church and that he followed God, he wouldn't have had a ministry right now where he inspires young people all over the world. He's from Savannah, Georgia, born Maurice Hicks, but now he is Uncle Reese with t-shirts that say, "Without Jesus, I suck." And I can understand that for sure. Some of us do not get it, but I totally get it. Check out his video, Until I Pass Out. You'll love it just as much as we do.
Yes.
Oh,
set free. See, I may look like money, but you don't know what I've been through. And I'm still going through some of it, so dancing is something that I gotta do.
Video with Uncle Reese. I know I did. It made me want to whip my hair. I mean, the way he was just moving them dreads, Lord have mercy, and just praising God. That's what I want you to get excited about. Make sure that you check him out on Tumblr, UncleReese.tumblr.com, and the new song Until I Pass Out is available on iTunes and Amazon.com. So make sure you support independent artists, because that's what we love to do here on the Gaps of Diva Show. Next, I want to introduce to you one of our sponsors. We have a new product coming out. It's hitting the market. It's a fierce product. I think everybody needs it. It's a product that will motivate, inspire you, and smack some sense into you. Check it out. One of our sponsors, Gaptooth Diva Smack Right.
Problem with self-esteem? Are you having low confidence? Well, maybe you need to try GaptoothDiva Smack Right, the newest product on the market that's making you believe in yourself.
My name is Myrtle and I have really low self-esteem. Do you think that GaptoothDiva Smack Right will work on me?
Damn right, Myrtle. GaptoothDiva Smack Right is formulated to make you feel awesome by smacking some sense into you.
But I have a gap too, and I don't really like to smile. Do you think Smack Right can help with that?
Open up the can and let's see. Pow! Now you have confidence.
Thanks, GaptoothDiva. Now I can smile with confidence.
But wait, there's more. GaptoothDiva's smack right gives you more confidence. Therefore, more people are attracted to you.
Really? Because I really want to start dating again.
Damn right, Myrtle. Now open up the can again and let's see. Pow! Now don't you feel sexy?
Now I feel sexy enough to find me a man. Thanks, GaptoothDiva. I feel like I just got smack right.
Pow! Smack right success! That's right. GaptoothDiva smack right. $3.99 on GaptoothDiva.com for a limited time only. GaptoothDiva smack right. Believe in yourself.
Okay, so that was GaptoothDiva smack right. GaptoothDiva smack right is also available for free delivery. It's $3.99 on GaptoothDiva.com. It's positive empowerment and inspiration like a smack in your face. Make sure you go to GaptoothDiva.com to get yours, or if you need me to, I will personally deliver it to your house for you. All right, now we're getting ready to get into our interview. Well, not really an interview. It's more of a dialogue, a conversation with two amazing people that I know personally who've been doing some great things in the community, have been doing great things in business, and they did it being themselves, being individuals, and in their own unique way. First is Andrea Bennett from Fat Divas Modeling Agency. She's a plus size model. She is a mother. And she's been doing some great things with plus size girls. And we know each other from high school. Yes, yes. We went to school together. And we both grew up not being as confident and self-assured as we are today. And then we also have the beautiful Fennix Baldwin, hairstylist, female impersonator, and also an entrepreneur and the founder and creator of the Hair Battle Royale. If you've been checking me out at GaptoothDiva.com, I featured their very first event, which went amazingly well. And you've just been doing things ever since. Like, you've had events and everything. Now, I want to talk to you guys about initially, growing up, just being who you are, not now, but back then, how difficult was it for you with people, you know, having their own insecurities and maybe talking about you or saying stuff? And I want to start with you, Andrea.
Well, I know for me, I had a very low self-esteem. I wasn't confident. I was picked on a lot, and I just didn't think being plus size was beautiful.
Okay. And what about you?
Well, I can say, far as me growing up, I really didn't have that, you know, negative vibe far as me being, well, of course, you know, I'm a gay male.
Uh-huh.
I really didn't have that negative vibe from the individuals around me. So I was actually allowed to be, you know, who I wanted to be.
So you were able to be a gay male? Yes. With everybody that you were with?
Yes. Uncles, aunts, cousins, you know.
But when you went to school, was there?
I mean, it was some backlash in school, but it wasn't that much because I kind of went to school with neighborhood friends. Mm-hmm. So most people that I went to school they already knew.
Okay. And see, that's very different from what Andrea and I experienced because, I mean, of course, we didn't have the stigma of being a homosexual in the mm-hmm. community, but we were just fat. You know, basically, yeah. I mean, let's just keep it real. We were just fat. I was fat and gap too. And we just, you know, we had insecurities about who we were. We didn't have the acceptance. And I just want to know from your perspective, if you had to deal with that growing up, do you think that would have changed you to who you are now?
I can't say that it would change me from who I am now. I could say I probably would be a little more humble.
Mm-hmm.
You know, sometimes people can say confidence can be quite cocky.
Mm-hmm.
And I feel like when you're validated as a child, then sometimes you grow up with a certain confidence. And that's what happened to me, you know, as a child. You know, I was always validated. People always told me, you know, who I was, I can be who I want, you know. So it never really, you know, played a part in who I became as an adult.
Okay. And I just want to let everybody know you can feel free to give us a call with any questions or concerns at 804-915-5555. 5202. Again, that's 804-915-5202. And we look forward to hearing your voice. We want to hear your questions and concerns because we don't have a problem answering them, okay? Now, getting back into it. Now, for you, Andrea, I personally want to say that with me growing up, feeling some insecurities about who I was. I mean, I had to deal with it not only at school, but at home. You know, my own family felt I wasn't adequate enough. They felt like I wasn't attractive enough. And because I dealt with it at home, I think that when I went to school, it was a different way of dealing with it. You've dealt with some bullying, yes. With people picking on you and talking about you. And as nice of a person as you were, I just don't think that you got your just dues, you know what I mean? When it came to people, you know, talking about you and treating you wrong. And I think that I also played a role. So me personally, I want to say on live television that I was a bully because I was insecure and I felt inadequate about my own flaws or whatever you say about them. I took it out on people like Andrea to take it off of me. And I just want to apologize for that here on live TV because we are grown now and yes. We are better people. Hold on, I'm going to answer the call. You're on with the Gaptooth Diva Show.
Hello, Gaptooth Diva. How are you?
I'm fabulous. How are you?
Make a comment or even ask a question. Hey, best friend, this is Shamir. Anyway, I was calling to ask you guys, do you think that if when you come from a positive family with people who allow you to be yourself in the home, do you think that that gives you a good outlook on when you go out into the world, you can be whoever you want to be? Mm-hmm. And I also want to say, do you think if you have a negative environment at home, it can also have an effect on your lifestyle when you leave the home and your comfort zone?
Well, I absolutely think that's true. Like Fennix Baldwin mentioned, you dealt with support. People were supportive of who you were mm-hmm. and what you were about. And, you know, now you're growing up, you're a grown person, you have confidence, and that's one of the biggest things that resonates with you and your personality.
Now, don't get me wrong. It was some idiots in the bunch.
Yeah.
You know, but the confidence kind of overshadowed it.
All the parents and the guardians that's raising children, to let your children know that they are loved, so that way when they go out here and they face these cruel people in the world, they can hold their head up and know that there's only one or two people's small-minded opinion, and you ladies have a great night.
You too. God bless. Bless you. Bye. I totally agree with that. I mean, if I grew up with some of the support that I get now, I probably wouldn't have wasted my time bullying people or going right. down the wrong path because I made a lot of bad decisions because I was insecure within myself. If I had some of the support that you could be whoever you want to be and that you're just awesome the way you are, you know, things would have changed. But we all have to go through some things for a reason. You're on with Gaptooth Diva Show. How can I help you?
Hey, Diva.
Hi.
I'm the biggest fan. I'm just so happy for you. I'm just so glad that you was able to get your own show. You're doing your thing. We're so proud of you all here.
Thank you. Thank you.
I mean, you just an inspiration to me and so many other people. I mean, you have flaws, and you teach us that it's okay to have flaws. And I mean, you just changed my life.
That's awesome. What's your name, sweetheart?
My name is Gerard.
Thank you, Gerard. I really appreciate your support.
I'm going to leave you alone. I'm going to let y'all do y'all thing, but I just had to call in and show my support.
Thank you. Thank you. Bye. Okay. Thank you, Gerard. That's awesome. I feel good. Okay. I'm sorry.
You should feel good.
That made me feel good. Yes. But yes. I really want to know because you both have different stories. Mm-hmm. I want to know, how did you get through it? What was that pinnacle point in your life where you said, I'm not going to feel bad about myself? I know it wasn't any help to me or any other people. It had to be, you know, that you did it on your own, and I want to know how.
Prayer, and I found modeling, and modeling gave me confidence.
Mm-hmm. I remember the first day you was modeling, girl.
I was nervous.
Cool, oh, my gosh. Yeah.
I was so nervous.
What about you? When did you decide, okay, now I've had this support with my family and I can be who I am, I'm going to take it a step further and do female impersonate?
Well, I guess that was years ago. But when I decided to do it, it was actually, I actually wake up every day to do something new. So that day I woke up and I decided to put on some hair and, you know, to become this fabulous individual that I am today. Mm-hmm. It was actually my own self choice. I can't say that I actually decided it, because as a gay male, I always, you know, love the attribute of a woman and things like that. So I kind of like getting glamorous and fabulous and everything like that. So I can't say I just decided it overnight. It was just like I woke up one day and I decided to put on hair and everything. And it was embraced so much by the community and women and men, you know, per se, that I just stuck with it.
Now, do you get negative backlash? I mean, there are women that may feel, how dare he think that he can just put on a dress and some makeup and go through, you don't get your menses, you can't have a baby. Like, you know, it's some things that you don't get to experience that we have to go through.
Yeah, I mean, there is some backlash, but I can't say that women will actually say that per se to me. Mm-hmm. You know, they may talk about it amongst girlfriends or somewhere, but I've never had any backlash in my ear per se. And I have a wonderful amount of girlfriends that actually support what I do. I mean, they understand it more so than I say it should be backlash. Now, they do have questions, don't mm-hmm. get me wrong. They want to know, like, what do you do mm-hmm. to actually do this? And mm-hmm. but it's nothing really major. I just put on some makeup and some hair. I never had anything done. You mm-hmm. know, I'm just naturally this person.
Yeah.
So whether I do it as a guy or a girl, you know, this is just me.
Well, I can say for certain that people can say what they want about you, but I've never seen a more supportive mother than your mother. I mean, she would be at the shows just popping bottles, and that's my baby, and ones in her hands, and it's like, I wish I had that kind of mom, you know yeah. what I mean?
I love my mother so much, and she definitely has played a part in my support team on how I view and go about my life.
Okay.
And she's always told me, you know, you be whatever you want to be. You don't let nobody tell you what you can't be. That's why we were born in this good old great country
of
ours.
That's right. That's yeah. right. Now, was your parents supportive of you growing up?
Well, my mom was, and my dad as well. I was always daddy's little girl.
Okay.
Yeah. So they were always supportive of what I wanted to do.
So you just got the negativity outside of your home?
Yes.
Wow. Yes. Wow. So it was like leaving the house for you was like a crapshoot. You just never yes. knew what you were going to get. How did you feel back then? I honestly want
to
know.
I used to be depressed a lot. I stayed to myself. I was always in my room with my music mm-hmm. and my TV, just doing my own thing.
Wow.
I'm
really proud to hear that you just decided to find something that really made you happy, and that, you know, the behavior of people, and myself included, didn't cause you to do anything that would be detrimental to you being as fabulous as you are right now. I'm serious, because I mean, bullying is a really serious issue.
It is.
And most of the time we don't think about the fact that there's a reason behind it. I don't know not one bully who isn't experiencing some type of bullying themselves, whether mm-hmm. it's from a family member or other friends, whether it's abuse, or people just don't feel awesome and feel amazing and leave out the house and say, I'm gonna pick on that person. It's right. really some underlying issues. And I'm just glad that you didn't experience it as much as I would have expected, considering the fact that you are a gay man mm-hmm. and that, you know, you didn't experience it as bad as that you did. Okay, let's go ahead and get another call. You're on with the Gaptoothed Diva Show.
Hey, how y'all doing tonight?
We're fabulous. How are you?
I'm fine. You know, this is my first time catching your show, and I just like to say it's a nice chest-to-chest show, you know what I'm saying?
Oh, well, thank you. It's the first show, so you're lucky.
Yeah, I gotta say this, you know, I like that women feel secure about themselves, and I gotta tell you, Gaptoothed Diva, you're a nice-looking woman, you know that?
Oh, thank you.
You're welcome.
I appreciate it.
How many more shows do you think you're going to have on here?
We have a season. We have 5 more shows coming up every Wednesday at 7:30.
Yeah, no doubt. All right. You just keep coming on TV, and I'll keep on coming on this phone.
Oh, you going to come on the phone? Okay. Thank you. Bye. Anybody else heard that? He gonna come on the phone.
Yeah.
Thank you. Appreciate it.
Yes.
He needs to know that you are married, honey.
Yes.
Yes.
Thank you.
Yes. married.
He needs to know that.
But I still want you to tune in.
Yes, definitely. Yes. All ratings.
Okay. So anyway, back to what I was talking about. Okay, so my personal story, like I dealt with the bullying at home. Like I was too dark, had a gap, and I was fat. And I was too loud and too outgoing to have a gap and be fat at the same time. So I was taught that you need to be quiet, keep to yourself, and be smart. Because you're not pretty, so be smart. And then when I got to school, I had to hear it from people. Oh my God, you got a gap and you fat and all this. So it was just like, you're not going to be able to do this. You're not going to be able to do that. I would have never in my life imagined that I would be on television. Would never in my life imagined I'd be walking down somebody's runway, right, taking pictures. Lord God, it's just a blessing. But it took me going through some very hard times. I mean, myself was also depressed. I took it out on myself. I was a cutter. I was suicidal. I just went through it all. And while I was battling it, trying to keep it to myself, you know, at the time, I felt like I was going to pick on whoever to get the attention off of me. You know what I mean? So when I was in high school, I would have picked on the gay boy. I would have picked on the other big girl because it would have took the shine off of me. And as long as I'm picking on you and I'm throwing punchlines your way, nobody notices the pain that I'm experiencing myself. Right. But as I got older and I realized, you know, that I'm beautifully made because God don't make no junk. You know what I mean? Like, you,
God,
whatever
doesn't
flaw
make
you,
mistakes,
he don't make that's any mistakes. Right. It's people out there that's just amazing with just what they have. No enhancements, no corrections, no nothing. So how dare I take this time to take away what God put here? I'm here for a reason. And I am not my own. So therefore, whatever I utilize my time on this earth for, because I should have been dead a long time ago. So whatever I use my time on this earth for, I'm hoping to inspire other people like us to know you are just awesome. Mm-hmm. So whether you get the support from your mommy and daddy, you got the support from me. Mm-hmm. Whether the people in your neighborhood, your school, or whatever love you, we love you. Mm-hmm. Just the way you are. No additives or nothing. You are just amazing the way you are. And you too, I mean, like, when I watch you perform, when I watch Zakiya and all your little crew perform, I'm thinking it's a lot of women that could really learn a lot from these men up here doing this. I mean, just performance wise, how you carry yourself, your what's it, je ne sais quoi, just the way you hold yourself up. A lot of women don't have that confidence. And I remember, you know, Andrea and I, first modeling, think casting call, we were very shy and all that. Can we do that? I mean, can we wear leggings like that? I mean, can we do that? We were very shy. And I was like, these women need to be with these women impersonators and somebody needs to network and teach. You know, how do you get that confidence? How do you turn it on just like that?
Well, I could say it's somewhat acting. Being a female impersonator is definitely acting. What you do is you sit in the mirror and you actually perform to yourself. Mm-hmm. I mean, the best place for you to be is in the mirror looking at yourself. Mm-hmm. You are your own judge. I mean, I've learned from some of the top female impersonators in this city that I can say I've learned to female impersonate from and actually to actually perform and things like that. Mm-hmm. Where do I get it from is definitely those women. We're going to say that how I build my confidence was actually looking in the mirror at myself and performing. And I know what I did wrong. You know, I had full body mirrors to actually grow and gain the confidence that I have right now today.
Okay. What about you, Andrea?
The same thing, like
in the mirror,
being in the mirror, I'm watching you on the runway, hit them poses at the end. You know, you can hit them poses so quick.
Yes. That's, I'm going to have to admit, I myself learned by looking in the mirror. You just sitting in the mirror, just, you know, holding it, hitting it, and it's like, oh, I look good doing this. Maybe I should do this more often. Yeah. And then when you walk out in public, then you just practice what you get. And it's also, too, when you're around positive people, people who are not afraid to tell you you're not looking good or you're looking amazing.
Exactly.
That really helped me because when I was around people who was always telling me this is ugly, you need to fix that and all this, it made me, you know, ball up.
It shrinks me.
It diminished me. It dimmed the inner light that I had.
But when I was around, people say, you look amazing. You should smile more often.
And you do.
You should talk more often. Just with anybody. Just like they had the confidence within themselves to give another person
a compliment.
A compliment. Mm-hmm. And say, girl, you look gorgeous. And I was just like, really? And then all of a sudden, I felt like, okay, I'm
you feel your shoulders start rising.
I don't want to be around anybody. not like that. You know what I mean? You are on with the GaptoothDiva Diva Show. How can I help you?
Hello, GaptoothDiva Diva. I'm calling because I am watching your show, and I really like your show. Congratulations, because there's not a lot of us that can do a lot of things coming out of Richmond. So, congratulations.
Thank you so much. Who am I talking to? who am I talking to?
My name is Deja
Mont. Oh, Deja, thank you so much. And to everybody, I love them too.
Thank you.
Thank you. Have a good night.
You too.
Bye. I'm just grateful for all y'all families and friends calling into the show. Just the cutest
the
thing.
The baby was like, oh my God.
The show's not over quite yet, so if you have any questions or comments, feel free to give us a call. It's 804-915-5202. Thank you. Y'all know the number. 849-155-202. Okay. So, like, oh, okay. Honey, you're on with the GaptoothDiva Diva Show.
Yes, good evening. How y'all doing?
We are fabulous. Hey. How are you?
Oh, I'm just wonderful. I just wanted to call and say this is an awesome show, and y'all are all beautiful.
Oh.
And I'm so glad I caught it, you know. And I wanted to ask the question, do you think bullying is calming down? And I'm going to get off the phone in case somebody else wants to call, okay?
I will answer your question. Thank you so much.
Thank you.
Good night.
Bye, night.
As far as bullying goes, I don't personally feel like it's calming down. I mean, I have a 5-year-old, and just the other day, he got picked on at school because he didn't have a name brand t-shirt on. It was the craziest thing. At 5 years old, I can't remember not ever knowing what name brand was.
Yeah.
But he was like, oh, that's fake polo. And I was just like, buy some real polo and talk to me at 5 years old. You on with the GaptoothDiva Diva Show?
Hey, Aisha, how are you?
I'm fabulous. Who is this?
You look amazing.
Thank you. I think I know who this is.
Well, you tell me who it is.
Is this the beautiful Zach here?
It very much is.
I'm fabulous. How are you?
I'm good. You guys look awesome. Fennix, you look beautiful. Your makeup is sitting. I wanted to tell you ladies to keep doing what you're doing and to rock and forget what people say. Push through, strive for what's best for you, and walk in God's word and watch what happens.
Just
push through.
Yes.
And be the best you can be.
Thank you so much, Zakia. Thank you.
Keep doing what you do for the community, girl. Mario, you keep doing what you do. Mm. And lady in the middle, I don't remember your name, but you are sitting there giving me everything I need.
We are here for this. Yes. Yes. Thank you. Bye. Okay, so obviously we got the support. God is good.
Yes. All the time.
All the time.
But really quick, I wanted to let y'all know, when people talk about flaws and stuff like that, people don't understand that there are some famous, influential people out there that's gorgeous in our eyes, but they all have flaws. And I went and did the research, honey. And let me just tell you, you talk about gap tooth and fat and all that stuff. Denzel Washington got a crooked pinky. Ashton Kutcher got webbed toes. Kelly Ripa, you know, Michael and Kelly, she's flat chested. Let's get back into it in just a second. You on with the GaptoothDiva Diva Show?
Hi, Aisha. This is Diamond.
Hi, Diamond.
Hi. I just want to I wanna give a shout out to my sister, Andrea Bennett. Yeah. I'm so proud of you, and I'm watching y'all right now.
Oh, thank you. Thank you so much for your support, honey. My fellow platinum blonde sister.
Yes.
Your hair is rocking tonight.
Thank you.
Oh my God, I was just telling my daughter, it's so pretty.
It glows in the dark, honey, but I'm not going to show you right now.
Okay. All right, y'all have a good evening.
All right, you too. Thank you.
All right, bye-bye.
Bye.
Oh, that's so crazy.
She is. So DJ Paul from 3-6 Mafia got a baby arm. I did not know that. I had no idea.
I never noticed it.
Shania Lathan and Megan Fox both have club thumbs. D-Rock from the Ying Yang Twins has nubs on his left hand. Forrest Whitaker, we all know he got that eye situation. Seal has a scarred face. And Joaquin Phoenix, one of my favorite actors that played Johnny Cash, has a cleft lip. There are so many actors and influential people that have flaws, and people always want to point out the smallest thing, and we all know why. Mm-hmm. It's because they're insecure within themselves. Mm-hmm. They're not, you know, they don't love themselves, which is why they're always picking on us. You know what I'm saying? They're going to say, GaptoothDiva don't need to be on TV with that big old gap in her mouth. She is too big, and anybody got no widescreen, so I can't even set my settings to watch her for real. And I understand. I get it. But you're only picking on me because you're feeling some type of way about yourself. Now, really quick, I just want to say thank you guys for being on the show.
Oh, yes.
I appreciate y'all coming on here with all of your fabulousness. I can't have this no more. It's too much fabulous at one time. Okay, one more call before we wrap things up. You're on with the GaptoothDiva Show.
Hey, I hear you, it's Jessica.
Hey, boo.
I was just calling to say congratulations. I'm watching the show.
Thank you. I appreciate it.
Thank you. Okay, I got just a little question, because I know you're talking about, like, flaws and stuff. Okay, so, you know, I'm not that tall, right? I'm kind of short.
Uh-huh.
So, and I don't like heels because they hurt my feet. So what can I do to, like, give me the illusion that I look a little taller?
Nothing. She just rock that shortness like you're sexy, right, boo. That's why aren't you trying to front like you're tall? I can't be skinny. I can't wear nothing to give me the illusion that I'm skinny. I can't wear nothing to give me the illusion that I don't have no gap. So you need to own that shortness like it is the Sunday morning and just walk around like it's beautiful and stop hating on yourself and try to put on heels and stuff. It's not going to work. And we don't do the illusions. Ain't nobody cross-eyed. We don't, our eyes ain't messed up. We know you short. You always going to be short. So own that shortness. Unless you're going to walk around on stilts and then I hope you fall because you hating on yourself, just. Okay.
Thank you. Congratulations.
Thank you, boo. Love you. Bye.
Love you
so
bye.
Oh, I love y'all.
Yes.
Wait till next week. We get ready to wrap up. Really quick, thank you so much for checking out the GaptoothDiva Show. Make sure you go to the poll. I can't take any more calls. I don't know how this is going to work. I can. Great. My producers tell me I can. You on with the GaptoothDiva Show?
Hey, how you doing tonight?
I'm great. How you doing?
I just like to say, you know, don't worry about what other people say about you, you know, because once you start worrying about what other people thinking about you, you know, you start to doubt yourself.
Absolutely.
And one thing you've been talking about tonight is always trust in yourself.
Yes.
And so, you know, if you got to worry about what the next person say about you, then you're giving them too much time.
Absolutely.
And like I said earlier, GaptoothDiva, you are a beautiful woman.
Oh, my Thank God. You.
It's calling back.
Back again.
Oh, my God. He's going to be on your call every week.
I know. Thank you so much. I appreciate it. Good night.
Bye, baby.
Bye. I'm going to start telling y'all to send them compliments to my PayPal. Okay? Make sure that y'all check out the new movie at the Bowtie Theater that's coming up on October the 4th at 7 p.m. Troop 491. Young Prince Charles is going to be in it. Support black movies. Support the kids. Support entertainment. Support local entertainment. And go check out this movie. It's about kids growing up and the circumstances that they're growing up and how brotherly love can change everything. Also, if you're going to be at, around tomorrow, meet me at Meet Your Tweet, which is a free event, networking event. It's going to be free. It's going to be on the boat. We're going to be having drinks. It's going to be lovely. It's from 6 to 9. Make sure you check out yoshiko.com. YoshikoEntertainment.com. And make sure you go to my website, GaptoothDiva.com, for fashion, music, culture, lifestyle, and inspiration. And I also do the Monday Jump Off every Monday morning at 6 a.m., which is a 30-minute motivational pep to carry you out throughout the week. Follow me on Twitter, Instagram, Facebook, Google, YouTube, everywhere. Just type GaptoothDiva. And also check out the networkgrind.com. Follow Andrea for Fat Divas Modeling Agency. How can I get in touch with you?
Facebook.com/FatDivasINC.
Okay, and you, Fennix Baldwin, a.k.a. Mario Lee, premiere season 4 of The Cutting Edge tomorrow here on Comcast as well. How can they get in touch with you?
Well, you can follow me on Twitter at REIO919, or you can follow me on Facebook at Mario Lee.
Okay. Well, it was so great having you. Like I always say, dream as if you'll live forever. Live as if you'll die today. You have just tuned in to the baddest creative motivation. It's the Gaptoothed Diva Show. Peace out. Two more minutes. I'm ready to wrap up. Well, okay, if you want to go on my YouTube page and check out my skit videos, my tutorials, and my rants, make sure you go to youtube.com/GaptoothDiva. And also, make sure that you check me out. I'm going to be featured on blackoftheberry.org. Again, Kiara Lee has me on her website under the successful, that's a tongue twister, and Successful Sisters page. I'm a successful sister. Ooh, and I'm spitting all over the place. So thank you so much for checking out everything that I have going on. I try to make sure this is the most empowering show on Comcast, and I'm excited to be here. I really thank you for having me. And tune in every Wednesday at 7:30 for more of the Gaptoothed Diva Show. Thank you. They're just going to have to watch us talk. I'm done. Watch me talk, honey. I'm so thankful to have y'all on the show.
Oh, thank you so much. 1 minute.
I'm so excited.
I mean it, like,
I know, right?
Hey, if he did it before, he could do it again. If he did it before, he could do it.